une jeune qui vient avec son masque pour nous prouver qu'elle a vraiment son masque. Et elle vient avec un studio. La donner Oni. Oni. Non, montrez votre masque, il n'y a pas de problème, la donner.
Oui, c'est
Bonjour.
mon masque.
Voilà,
Bonjour,
voilà.
bonjour. Good morning, dear.
Vous l'avez acheté à combien?
My mom gave me.
Elle vous a donné?
Yeah, my mom.
Ah, d'accord. Elle a acheté à combien?
Je suis sûre qu'elle a fabriqué elle-même.
My mom gave me, and if you really want to buy yours, I know, Sandra, you know the market, right?
Why should I be the one to
So
He knows
it's better if
the
you show
market
him the
too.
roads to the you show him the road to the market. That
He
would be good.
wants the one that was fabricated by your mom.
Anyways, we're starting with coronavirus
Sure.
update. And we're going to start with Cameroon, where over 7,000 people have been sensitized yesterday in the far north region of Cameroon, in villages like Fadara, Malam, Pété. The authorities visited the inhabitants of this area, counseling them on what to do to prevent the coronavirus. So it's a good initiative, especially in the interiors, in the hinterlands, where there is no light and they don't have access to the TV or the internet to be sure or to be aware of the current health crisis. So going to those in hinterlands to sensitize the population, it's an amazing initiative because you could see them carrying different buckets of water or small jugs of water, distributing, demonstrating you need to wash your hands, holding a plaque or some a board,
Banner,
a
yeah.
banner that says, okay, this is what you should do, or this is when you're having this is how you should cough, this is how you should sneeze, this is how you should behave around people and all of that, sensitizing people on how to prevent the coronavirus. Still on sensitization campaign, the people from the civil service, they also went to the Banyo prison, sensitizing over 150 prisoners and seven guards in the Adamawa region while distributing soap and jugs of water. They went out sensitizing the prisons. The image on the screen isn't the sensitization campaign in the Adamawa region. Yeah, this is a sensitization campaign in the Adamawa region where they were distributing jugs of water, jugs like they could use to wash your hands in the Banyo prison. Prisons are one place, if anybody gets coronavirus in a prison, that means the rest of them, it's just going to be bad because it's so congested and our prisons are so full that people, you can't afford to stay 1 meter away from somebody. You have to be close to that person. That means you get give you 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 you, you spread it to a person and it spreads it to the whole prison. So they went out sensitizing the prisoners at the Banyo prison in the Adamawa region while distributing jugs of water and soap, and also telling them of the different measures on how to prevent the spread of the coronavirus. In the Southwest region as well, a sensitization campaign was being carried out. Face masks were being distributed to the population. You can see it on your screen. The face masks were being distributed to the population and they were being told on how to wear their face mask, when to wear their face mask, and also different measures on how to prevent the spread of the coronavirus. Still on the since still in the Southwest, we have the senior divisional officer for FACO, that is Engamba Emmanuel Edu, has warned all the parents in the FACO FACO to stop sending their children to hawk.
Okay.
During this period, it's so common.
That's beautiful.
It's so common that people go out during this period where there is no school. Mothers, you can see parents sending out their children to go and hawk.
I see several hawking water along the streets.
Yes,
to go
and hawk. It's not right because at this time the children are more exposed to this chemo pandemic, because the go around, when you leave a child loose during this period, he or she just interacts with anybody. And the moment your child or a child in the quarter in the neighborhood has that virus, he can easily spread it to other children in the neighborhood, and it can come to you because you interact with that child at home. At this period, it's a time for us to take care of our children, make sure they are at home, and make sure they don't go around visiting people anyhow, except it is so important. So he has sent out the communique warning every parent that will send the child this season to go and hawk, that he is going to catch the child, seize the goods, and summon the parent for questioning.
That's interesting, because it's really horrible. They won't talk about a pandemic like this one that is ravaging several people, and then you still have the mind to send your kids to go hawk. I really, it's true, at times when parents have the opportunity for their kids to stay back home. Some of them are happy because they say, okay, it's a situation, it's an opportunity for you to stay back home and help. And some of the kids too are super happy to be able to lend a helping hand to their parents out there. But if it's really at this particular moment, it is not advisable. And one thing too with the face mask that I've noticed, most of the face masks that do, I mostly see for the older people. I haven't really seen a demonstration on how to do little face masks for kids.
For kids.
That's an issue. We are not the only ones who need to protect ourselves using the face masks. Our kids too, whether 3 years or how many, they are actually supposed to have their own face masks too. And it will really be a good initiative for these masks to be plastified, maybe put in wrap ones, because true. I noticed they were just sharing just like that. You know you're walking, you might be confronted with dust, mud, and all. I mean, the air might be polluted. It's really good for them to be put in plastics and little papers, so that when the people collect, they could go back home and why not maybe wash or something before using. I really don't understand how I am on set. Gosh, it's horrible.
Okay, the Cameroon Association for Bible Translation and Literacy, CAPTAL, has joined the fight against the COVID-19 by translating booklets on coronavirus into over 21 local languages. Oh. So that's their own contribution in this crisis, health crisis, by translating over a booklet to over 21 local languages, translating it to 21 local languages. That's, it still works in line with more sensitizing people, because like I said earlier in the show, earlier on last week, I said many people do not understand the French or the English. There are some people that just understand their local languages, and for you to get more closer to the grandma in the village or the grandpa in the village, you should be able to tell him in his dialect. He's going to understand that better. So you translating it, it's so good, because as a child that is reading the booklet to his grandpa, the grandpa feels okay because you are reading it in his dialect where he could easily apprehend or understand it.
That's a beautiful initiative. Anyone last for the road?
That's all. I had only Cameroon updates for today, so that will be all for today.
Thank you very much, Ladinette, for stopping by, and we pray that several people out there would have so many of such initiatives instead of trying to do everything for their own personal benefit. Let's go check on our publicity page, and just behind we have the review of the newspapers with René Nassis-Moto.
Monsieur Zonrala,
ma fille Andelam,
et bien du coup,
Gavin, on l'a top.